My name's Lily, and I'm trying to go public for some strange reason. I feel like I need to tell my story, and I have a passion to tell you about myself, mainly because I see myself as a communications trainer, as a motivational trainer. And many years ago, I was a laboratory assistant for the Department of Health in Melbourne. And then I decided to travel and I went overseas. I was born in Melbourne, in Australia, where I grew up. And this was in Melbourne at the National Biological Standards Laboratory, where we were testing vaccines. Now, very important matter. At that time, the NBSL, National Biological Standards Laboratories, were in Melbourne, in Parkville, and they have since moved to Canberra. And I was working there for a year and a half and training as a laboratory assistant, going to night school and doing lots of other things in my teenage years. And then I decided to travel. I first sent my parents to Europe, and when they came back and I wanted to leave home to regain my independence, which I had for the 6 months while my mother was away and I took care of the household, I got a job in Switzerland, and I was working in a nursing home in Muri Aargau, in the German-speaking part of Switzerland, and I was called Schwesternhilfe. They called me Schwester Lily. This is Frau Capelli, and she was dement. We had many different patients with various disabilities or just simply aged. And this is me accompanying her on a walk in the corridor. I was responsible for the private ward the last couple of months before I left, and I was doing night duty. Anyhow, it was that time that I was working in Switzerland that I had a lot of experiences, a lot of time for thinking, philosophizing. I traveled a lot around Europe, Switzerland, Austria, and then even for 1 month on the Ural Pass up to Narvik to see the midnight sun, and down to Turkey, where I spent 3 weeks at a Turkish beach resort, which was actually belonging to the Turkish army when the war broke out in Cyprus. Anyhow, I returned back to Australia because a friend of mine who met my brother's best friend decided that they were going to get married and I had to be at their wedding because it was my farewell party where they met. And so I was responsible for them having met. And I came back and first I was actually a housemaid waitress in the outskirts of Melbourne, 100 kilometres from the city, in a convention centre. And it was one day while I was walking along a river towards the waterfalls, the Marysville Falls, that I decided that my life would only have meaning if I could help other people. And I decided to do the nurse training at the Royal Melbourne Hospital. I quickly became the student nurse representative of all the big, this is half the group. This was 35 students, and there was another 35 students in the other group. And I was the group leader for the whole student nurse contingent of that year in 1975. And it was the first time that we had male nurse students. So actually what I wanted to talk about was, why did I give up nursing when I felt that was my calling? And I decided that I wanted to be a nurse because I wanted to help people. And then when I met the unification movement and I heard the principles, I came to understand that actually the principles answered so many of the questions that I had and could help even more people than what I could help physically as a nurse. It became clear to me that the fact that I understood these principles that were being taught to me put me in a very special position where it was my responsibility to teach it. So over the next few years, I was teaching the principles. And I'm asking myself now, what happened? Why haven't I been teaching these principles? And it's now after my retirement from the IAEA, after my two knee operations, still in the process of recovering, and in the last week of May, as I set myself a certain deadline to determine my path, to define my area of what I really want to do, I want to teach these principles. And a part of that is now figuring out how to tell my story. So this is my effort to begin to tell my story. And if I can do this each day for the rest of this month, then the goal would be the 1st of June, a new beginning. Well, I'm still so tentative and I wouldn't say non-committal, just insecure. Isn't that incredible? For all that I've done, I was a student nurse leader at the Royal Melbourne Hospital, 70 nurses. I organized the PTS graduation ceremony at the Royal Melbourne Hospital. I got the staff, the nursing staff and the admin staff and the professional staff and the medical staff to all work together to create an interdenominational service for the conclusion of our 10-week training when we were let loose on the ward in the Royal Melbourne Hospital. So I don't know. I'm going to finish here now and see ya.